Korean slang and colloquial expressions. We'll let you know the most commonly used Korean expressions in English. Hello everyone! Today, we'll start off with the expression number 41, and that is 자세 나오다. 자세 나오다 is a verb, and it means to look like an expert at something or to be in good posture. And the Korean definition is 아주 많이, a lot of times, so many times, 해본, have done it, 솜씨가 보이다. So he or she looks very skillful. 전문가의 모습으로 보이다. It looks like he or she is an expert at something. And the dialogue goes like this. 상경 says, 너 춤 잘 춘다며? I heard you're a great dancer. Then Mari goes, 못 추진 않지? I guess I'm okay. Then 상경 says, 야, 나도 좀 가르쳐줘. Hey, teach me some moves. Then Mari goes, 응, 기본 스텝만 좀 보여줄게. Okay, let me show you just the basic steps. Then 상경 says, 우와, 자세 나오는데. Wow, you look like an expert. Then Mari says, 뭐, 이 정도 가지고. It's just the basics. Well, the literal translation of 자세 is posture, but you don't necessarily use this expression to talk about someone's posture, so try not to get hung up on the word 자세 too much when you use this expression. Okay, here comes more example sentences for you. 우와, 자세 나온다. Wow, you look professional. 어때? 자세 나오지? What do you think? Do I look like I know what I'm doing? Okay, the next expression for the day is 산티나다. 산티나다 is a verb, and it means to look cheesy, or cheap, or vulgar, or even slutty. And the Korean definition is 천박하거나 싸구려처럼, vulgar, or superficial, or cheap, 보이다, looks that way. And here we go with the dialogue. 연수 says, 저 드레스 정말 예쁘지 않니? Isn't that dress gorgeous? Then 진표 says, 아니, 별로. Not really. Then 연수 says, 내가 사달라고 그럴까봐 이러는 거야? Is it because you're afraid that I might ask you to buy it for me? Then 진표 says, 아니, 난 저런 스타일 별로야. No, I just don't think it looks good at all. Then 연수 says, 뭐가 어떻길래 별로라는 거야? What makes you say that? Then 진표 says, 산티나잖아. It looks cheap and cheesy. Okay, if you were to break up the word 산티나다, 산 is an adjective meaning cheap, and 티나다 or 티가 나다 is a verb phrase that has a meaning of look like something, or to look some way, or to have an air of something. For example, if someone says, 그 남자는 가짜 티가 난다. That means he looks fake, or he has an air of being fake. And just so you know, the opposite of 산티나다 is 부티나다. And this can be used when you describe someone or something as looking glamorous and has an air of superiority. Alright, let's go over a few example sentences using 산티나다. 그 넥타이 너무 산티난다. That tie looks too cheesy. And 이거 산티나니? Does this look cheap? Great! Then let's move on to the next expression. The expression number 43 is 촌스럽다. The meaning of 촌스럽다 is to be tacky and unstylish. And the Korean definition, 옷 입은 모습이, the way someone dresses, 가난한 시골에서 온 것처럼, as if he or she is from a very poor rural town, 구식이다. Something or someone that's old-fashioned or outdated. And let's go through the dialogue together. Here says, 이 옷 어때? How do I look? Then 반석 says, 촌스러워. You look tacky. Then here says, 뭐? 촌스럽다고? 이게 얼마짜린데? What? Tacky? You just don't know how expensive it is. Then 반석 says, 비싸다고 다 좋은 게 아니야. High price doesn't guarantee quality. Then here goes, 광고에서 정우성이 입었을 때는 엄청 멋졌는데. It looked great when 정우성 was wearing it on the TV commercial. Denbansuk says, 정우성이니까 그렇지. That's because it's 정우성 who's wearing it. Well, I don't know about you, but personally, I hate being called 촌스러워. Well, you might be thinking that I hate it because I've been called 촌스러워 a lot, but that's not why I hate it. It's just that I want people to think that I look cool and smart, and that's just the way I want to look. So please don't call me 촌스러워 if you ever see pictures of me or see me in person. Alright, there are two example sentences prepared for you guys. 내 안경 너무 촌스러워. Your glasses look really unstylish. And the second one is 이거 촌스러워. Does this look tacky? Okay, moving on to the next expression. And it is 튀다 or 너무 튀다. 튀다 or 너무 튀다 is a verb and it means to stand out or stick out. And the Korean definition, 다른 사람들과 같이 있을 때, when someone is with other people, 혼자서만 너무 달라 보이다. He or she looks very different from them. And it's used like this in a dialogue. Hara says, 실내에서 웬 선글라스를 끼고 있어? Why are you wearing shades indoors? 혁수 says, 오늘 날씨가 좋길래. Because it's beautiful out today. Then Hara goes, 실내에선 좀 벗는 게 어때? How about taking them off indoors? Then Hyuk-su goes, 왜? 멋지지 않아? Come on, don't they look cool? Then Hara says, 멋있긴 한데 너무 튄다. They do, but you stick out from the crowd. Then Hyuk-su says, 튀고 싶어서 낀 거야. That's the whole point. Well, there's a slang we use a lot these days for the kind of people mentioned in the dialogue, like someone who wants to stand out from the crowd, so that they get everyone's attention, and it's called 관종. And it's an acronym for 관심종자. And the literal translation of 관심종자 is attention, 관심, and seed or breed is 종자. So if you paraphrase it, it refers to someone who likes getting attention a lot and almost to the extent of being addicted to it. I just wanted to mention it because it wasn't included in this book. All right, let's go on to the next expression, and it's going to be the last one for the day. The word is 꼬시다. 꼬시다 means to tempt someone or to talk someone into doing something or to hit on or pick up a girl or a guy. And the Korean definition, 끌릴 만한 말로, using words that may draw someone's attention, 상대방이, the other person or the person you're talking to, 어떤 일에 동참하게 하다. Make him or have him take part in something, 이성을 유혹하다, to seduce or hit on a girl or a guy. And the dialogue goes like this. 승엽 says, 여자 꼬시는 방법 좀 가르쳐줘. Tell me how to pick up a girl. Then Chani says, 나도 몰라. I don't know how to do that either. Then 승엽 goes, 에이, 네가 선수라는 거 다 알고 있어. Come on, I already know that you're a big-time player. Chani says, 누가 그래? Who told you that? Then 승엽 goes, 내 주변엔 항상 여자가 많잖아. You're always surrounded by so many girls. Then Chani says, 그걸 보고 바로 풍요 속의 빈곤이라고 하는 거야. It's like what they say, poverty in the midst of plenty. Well, let's go over the example sentences right away. The first one goes like this. 내가 그 애를 꼬셨지? Did you talk him into doing it? And the second one, 너 나 꼬시는 거니? Are you hitting on me? As you see from these two sentences, sometimes 꼬시다 means to talk someone into doing something, and other times it means to hit on or flirt with someone. How do you distinguish them? Well, you just have to figure it out by the context. You know, once you get used to it, it's not going to be that difficult. All right, that'll be all for now. Let's talk about more expressions in the next lecture. Goodbye.